Hey folks, thanks for tuning in. And in today's video, I'm going to share my thoughts on the Big Agnes Tiger Wall Ultralight Bikepacking Tent. So many of you may or may not know, Big Agnes recently launched their bikepacking range of tents last year. And just a few weeks ago, they actually updated their lineup with the Tiger Wall Ultralight bike pack that you see here, both in 2- and 3-person tents. The Tiger Wall fits kind of in the middle of the Copper Spur and Fly Creek. It's a little bit lighter than the Copper Spur, but it also has a few more features than the Fly Creek itself. Not only does this tent pack down really well, but it also comes with 2 doors, unlike the Fly Creek. So it has a little bit more versatility, especially if you are sleeping with 2 or 3 people. So before we take a look at the tent, I just wanted to show you kind of the difference between the Tiger Wall regular poles versus the Tiger Wall bike pack poles. Obviously, the Tiger Wall bike pack poles are much shorter. And as you can see, I would say probably 6 inches shorter or so. I've been using the Tiger Wall Platinum 2 for roughly 2 years. And it's been my go-to tent because not only is it durable, but it packs down. And a lot of those features kind of carry over to the bikepacking tent. So let's jump into it. I also wanted to just ask you all for a quick favor. If you could, make sure to hit that subscribe button. That will just ensure each one of our videos pops up in your feed. And another way to help support us is consider joining the Bikepacking Collective. If you haven't heard of the Bikepacking Collective, it's a yearly membership with bikepacking.com that signs you up automatically for monthly giveaways, includes industry discounts, and also ships to your door twice a year the Bikepacking Journal. Not only does the Bikepacking Collective help fund the Bikepacking Journal, but it also helps support the video that you are watching right now. So I will make sure to leave a link in the description below so that you can learn more about the Bikepacking Collective. Let's get on to the review. So the Big Agnes Tiger Wall Ultralight Bikepack comes in 2 sizes. We've got the 2-person tent and a 3-person tent. I tested out the 2-person tent, so we're gonna be talking specifically about the 2-person tent. I am 5'10", equal length to torso, and basically when I'm sitting up in the tent like this, especially when I'm on my sleeping pad, I don't really have any issues when I'm in the middle of the tent. The moment I go over to the side of the tent, there is more likelihood for me to rub up against the side because the way this kind of tapers down. But when I'm right in the middle, I definitely don't have any issues. The tent's height in its highest point is 99 centimeters or 39 inches. The tent's length is 218 centimeters or 86 inches long, which is plenty for me. And then the tent does taper a little bit, so you have more room up in the head than you do down at your feet. So this tent has a head width of 132 centimeters or 86 inches. And down at your feet, we have 107 centimeters and 42 inches. So definitely a drastic taper, but I never really noticed it being too cramped at my feet. That being said, having heads at the opposite direction may be a little bit cramped for the person that has their head down at the foot of the tent, especially with this overhanging pocket at the foot of the tent. That would prove to be a little bit more difficult, but it's not impossible. So the vestibule area is super nice because it does add some additional workable space in the tent, especially with this elongated ground cloth. The additional vestibule space is 66 centimeters or 26 inches out. So after my recent trip, I weighed this tent. So I weighed the body, the fly, the tarp, and the poles. And that came out to 1.33 kilograms or roughly 2 pounds and 15 ounces. This whole system packs really well into my Revelate Designs Vol or my Bedrock Bags Black Dragon seat packs, excluding the poles. The poles then will either fit, in this instance, they fit really well into my full suspension frame bag, or they could even fit into my handlebar bag. So the Tiger Wall does come with a very unique handlebar system from Big Agnes. The bag itself weighs 98 grams. So that bag will fit your poles on the outside. And then in the main compression compartment, it fits your tent body, the tent fly, and it will even fit the ground tarp, but it is super tight. The cool thing about that bag is it comes with a bunch of daisy chains, so you can maneuver it around a handful of different things that are mounted to your handlebars, and it's narrow enough that it will fit on drop bars. There's a number of different ways that we can set up the tent, basically three ways. We can set up the tent with the ground tarp and just the rain fly. We can set up the tent with the ground cloth and just the body, or we can set up the tent as you see here with all three. So the setup of this tent is actually pretty simple. All we have to do is either stake down the tarp, the ground tarp, or the body. You don't necessarily need the ground tarp. The ground tarp is sold separately, but the ground tarp is a super nice feature to have because it's almost like an entry mat to your tent. You can lay things out like your shoes on it. It basically extends the tent. So once you stake down the ground tarp or the body, if you don't want to take the ground tarp with you, all you have to do is install the poles into the tip lock pole buckle system. And this whole system is really simple to use because it's color coordinated. The buckles work really well and it's just mindless, to be honest. Once you have the pole into the tip lock buckle system, all you have to do then is clip the tent body to the poles itself and then add the cross beam on top of the main pole system. If you do end up installing the rain fly itself, there are some Velcro straps that should be Velcroed to the pole itself, and this will help maintain the structure and integrity, especially during a wind event. So a really unique feature of this Big Agnes tent is it uses a solution dyed fabric. And what that does is it cuts energy consumption by 80% and it cuts the water consumption in half during the manufacturing process. Not only is this tent more energy efficient to make, but it's more UV resistant, which helps maintain the color of the tent throughout its life. The remaining part of the body of the tent is just made out of a polyester mesh. And then the two-door system is identical on either side. Essentially, it just zips on the bottom and then on the top. While this is very nice to have two different zippers, it does take a little bit more effort to get in and out of the tent because you do have to unzip the bottom and unzip part of the top of the tent as well. And then talking about some of the outside features, this tent does come with a bunch of different ways that you can kind of keep your doors open, like so. There's also this red little door keeper, and if you really aren't as patient, all you have to do is just pull it through and your door is open. We've got this little helmet holder, which is nice. So this is one of our first bikepacking features that we're gonna talk about. I actually don't typically use this very often. I like to keep my helmet inside my tent because I've had rodents bite on the sweat of the band here. So I like to just keep that stuff that has a little bit of sweat inside the tent so I can help alleviate anything getting chewed up. And then right up top here, we just have these little daisy chains. If you have some wet belongings, they basically just store, say, you know, a shirt, a sweaty shirt or a wet shirt, some gloves, and you can kind of just keep them up here and they will dry off in the wind or overnight or in the sun, which is kind of a nice feature. Another awesome feature of this tent is the ability to kind of play with different orientations of having your vestibule open or closed. So in this case, we could just do a partial open like so. This side is identical to the other side of the tent, which is super nice. Both of them closed. And then there's some Velcro bits here that keep everything in place. If it's relatively warm and I'm at camp, I like to keep everything kind of open so that the tent breathes. This is where you're gonna spend a lot of time, right? And so having a comfortable space is important. Not only that, but having good storage is also important. And the Big Agnes Tiger Wall has just that. Before we get into those features though, I wanna talk about this little nylon siding here. This is really nice for being able to keep wind out, but it also, I feel like, keeps a little bit more of your heat or your warmth in. So it does keep maybe a little bit more moisture in, but on a cold night, you don't want a draft or anything. This whole panel here does a really good job of keeping your warmth in, but also keeping wind out. And then you obviously have the mesh that kind of starts up from here. So it still is relatively breathable. So this tent though is super impressive with pockets. Starting with the pockets up here above my head, this is a great pocket for electronics. I actually keep my inReach in here when I don't have service, and I keep it on so that I can communicate with my family. I also end up keeping my phone, maybe a battery pack up here, and maybe some electronics that I use for shooting video. So there's also some really nice pockets on the side, pockets for each individual for just personal items. I end up usually just using these small little ones for empty stuff sacks, just to keep them in place so I know where they are. And then lastly, this huge pocket up here where I usually keep my helmet, maybe my seat pack, some additional items. It's very large. At the same time, I try not to put too much stuff in here, especially heavy stuff, because I don't want to weigh down the body of the tent. So talking about this tent in the wind, let me tell you, I had a night full of 30 mile an hour gusts and it was scary, but the tent ended up holding up just fine. Like I mentioned, you want to make sure that the inner Velcro straps on the fly are attached. And then you'll also want to kind of just orient and make sure that if it is windy, make sure that you know what direction the wind is coming from so that you can orient this side of the tent directly to the wind, because that is the most stable. So I didn't get rained on per se, but when I did a trip in Minnesota, it was very humid, almost 90% humidity waking up in the morning. And with 90% humidity close to a water source, the tent is drenched. The tent fly is drenched. It did a really good job of separating the tent fly moisture with the tent body. The tent body was not wet at all, unless I actually had the tent fly touch it when I was taking it off. But it did a really good job of kind of separating that moisture. But the best thing was, the tent fly dried really quickly, even in a humid environment. Obviously, in a sunny Colorado environment like this, it's going to dry really quickly. But even in Minnesota, with a little bit of sun and just kind of trying to get the water off the tent fly itself, it dried relatively quickly. And if it was a little damp, and I would pack it a little damp into my seat pack, after I got to camp that evening, I would put the fly on and it would definitely be dry by the time I would go to sleep. So just talking about the durability and the structure of the tent, it's a three pole system. So you've got two poles up front and one at the bottom. And because of this, in a wind event, it does kind of move around a little bit more. Say if we had two up front and two at the bottom. And then just talking about the zippers a little bit, the fly zipper first off, I have from time to time gotten the zipper caught within the fly, but nothing is ripped or anything like that. And it actually does a pretty good job of avoiding doing that in the first place. You just have to be a little bit more careful. And then the zipper of the body itself, or I should say the two zippers of each door, I appreciate this because the more the curve is of the zipper, the more it is susceptible to becoming broken. So having these two should help the longevity of the zipper. And then lastly, just talking about the durability, the stitching, the cutting. So the cutting of these tents, it is super professional. You wouldn't even be able to know that this whole tent was at one point a big sheet of nylon. And I haven't had any issues with any of the stitching coming undone. And then the seamed seals too have done their job keeping water out. There is a little bit of stretching within the polyester mesh up here, which I always have from tents, which is unfortunate. I'm not sure what we can do to help avoid that. I do know that sometimes I have set up the body of the tent really tight. And so that definitely puts a little bit of undue stress on parts of the body of the tent. Quickly talking about the stakes itself, they are newly designed. They cut through ground really well. If it's frozen ground, rock, soil, it cuts through the ground and stays in place too. Over that night that I had 30 mile an hour gusts, the tent stakes did not move an inch, which was super awesome. So the price point is at about $450 United States. So that is expensive. But the fact that Big Agnes has innovated within the bikepacking and camping community to make bikepackers' lives easier, designing tent poles and tent features for bikepackers specifically, is pretty cool. The other thing is the energy efficient manufacturing process. In a day and age where we really need to be a little bit more conscious of our footprint, this is a tent that reduces that. And it's a tent that is durable, that should last a while as well. So paired with the energy efficiency and the durability, and the bike packing features, I think it's worth the price point. So if you have any comments or questions regarding the Tiger Wall ultralight bike packing tent, please put them in the comment section below. I hope that you enjoyed this video. And as always, thank you so much for watching. And until next time, pedal further.